networks for us. So in the news, you've seen the big in the news, the things that are high profile, where you've, some of these are probably familiar to you if you follow any of the cybersecurity issues, where Target had 110 million credit card numbers were stolen. Home Depot had reported 109 million of payment cards that were hacked. Sony, Anthem, recently the Anthem, where they had stolen 80 million Social Security numbers. And the list goes on and on. And from between 2013 and 2015, cyber crimes cost quadrupled in that time period. And it looks like there will be another quadrupling between 2015 and 2019. Juniper Research recently predicted that the rapid digitalization of the consumers, our lives and our enterprise records, that the cost for securing, the cost for these breaches will continue to increase to about $2.1 trillion by 2019. That's almost four times what it was just a year ago. So we see in the news all the Fortune 500 companies and names that you recognize, but there are more than 28 million small businesses out there that are also vulnerable to cyber attacks, and sometimes they get forgotten. Recently, if you watched the news last Friday, there was a denial of service attack on Dyn, who houses a number of the DNS names for Dropbox, Twitter, Netflix, and they impacted hundreds and thousands of companies and businesses. And you saw the big names out there, but how about all the small businesses that were also impacted? That denial of service attack ran from off and on between 8 o'clock and 5 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And the news is focused, of course, on the Fortune 500s and large companies, but the number of small businesses were also impacted by these types of security threats. So from a show of hands, how many remember keeping a secret, right? As a child, you kept a secret. Almost everybody can raise your hand, right? If this participation part. And as kids, we always kept, you know, we keep secrets all the time. Sometimes they're just silly and simple things, but usually they were between your friends, and often the secrets were trying to protect somebody else from not getting hurt, right? Don't tell Dad. All right, okay, I won't. No, otherwise, you know what the consequences are going to be, right? Who did that? It was the cat, Mom. It really was. They're the one. It climbed the tree, and it tipped it over. Okay. The real secret was, you know, the brother did it, right? But I won't tell. So how many as adults, we still keep secrets, right? We still have secrets that we keep, especially at our businesses, right? We have all kinds of information that we keep secret from an industry standpoint, from a trade secret standpoint. We have financial secrets, information at your business and such. And you have things that businesses have other information that they're required to keep secret, right? Personal information, medical information, social security numbers and such. And what you need is, sometimes you need that friend who you can share a secret with that you can trust. And Centricom, in this case, is a business partner that worked with this company because they could be trusted and the company could share some secrets with them that could be trusted to help, and so that Centricom could help them get through their situation. The worst secrets being kept today that are both small and large businesses are being overwhelmed by the cyber attacks. And our case study is here in Northwest Ohio. These are some headlines that you may have seen in the past. They're typical of cyber attacks that happen to small businesses. Perhaps someone opened an email they shouldn't have, or someone downloaded a user guide online that had malware built into it. We run into this all the time. We've seen companies right here in Northwest Ohio that have lost thousands of dollars and not realize it until their bank account was literally at the verge of depletion. You hate to see that when it happens. And it boils down to the, it's down to the risk of the integrity of the company, and the problems can be a little embarrassing too. So we've been hacked, and who?
The Orange and Black on 88.3 WLFC. Kirk Chiropractic provides wellness options to treat back pain. You can reach Kirk Chiropractic at kirkchiro.com. That's Kirk, C-H-I-R-O.com, or by calling 419-425-9798. Kirk Chiropractic, underwriting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Oiler Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is underwritten in part by KT Equipment Rental, located at 835 Western Avenue.
When I was six, my mom had a stroke.
I'm Paul George. Learn the signs of a stroke fast.
F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911. Spot a stroke fast.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
You're listening to Oiler Women's Basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Starting lineup time. We'll start with Hillsdale, led on the floor by their point guard, Allie Dwyer, a 5'6" sophomore from Toledo, Ottawa Hills High School, leading scorer for the Chargers at 14 points per game. The two guard will be a Maddie Reed, 5'9" junior from Oshkosh, Wisconsin. She averages 7 points per contest. Morgan Blair is the three spot in this three-guard lineup, 5'10", a senior from Livonia, Michigan, averaged 8 points per game. McKenna Ott, a 6-foot sophomore from Hazlitt, Michigan, she averages 11 points per game, also pulls down 4 rebounds. And the center position for the Chargers is Allie Dittmer, 6'1", junior from East Rapids, Michigan, averages 12 points per game, pulls down 8 rebounds. Chargers are coached by Todd Mitzmetzer, a second season at Hillsdale, 12-9 overall, 6-8 in the GLIAC. And now for the Oilers, the point guard, as it's been all season long, is Allie Toby, 5'7" sophomore from Maria Stein, Marion Local High School, averages 5 points per game, pulls down 2 rebounds. The two spot would be Haley Horseman, 5'8" junior from New Knoxville. Haley averages 8 points per game, pulls down 4 rebounds. The three spot would be Carly Boner, 5'9" senior from Shadyside. Carly averaged 7 points per game, pulls down 2 rebounds. Four spot for the Oilers, Anna Hint, 6'2" sophomore from North Fairfield, Ohio, South Central High School. Anna averages 9 points per game and 7 rebounds per game, and coming off a double-double performance where she had 13 points and 11 rebounds. Krista Putoff is the center, 6'2" sophomore from Versailles, averages 10 points per game, pulls down 5 rebounds. The Oilers are coached by Jim Wee. His fourth season as the head coach of the Oilers, 52 wins to 50 defeats. Coming to today's ball game, 10-12 overall, 4-10 in the GLIAC. Tonight's officials, Jeffrey Klaus, Christopher Oakes, and Monique Davis. So as we talked about, this Lady Oiler basketball team finds himself just 2 games out of the third spot in the GLIAC, and really that's pretty remarkable with how this season has been going, and see if that will maybe give them a little bit of a spark as we get into this last segment of the season. Just 6 games remaining, and we'll have 3 here at home, including this one, 3 on the road. So big opportunity here at home. If you get a win here today against Hillsdale, you pull to within 1 game of the Chargers, and then depending on how Ohio Dominican does and some others, along with Tiffin and Lake Erie and Walsh, who knows where you could be at heading into next week. Oilers will be off on Saturday, so no game here in Croy on Saturday. No away game either. Oilers will be on the road next week, Thursday and Saturday game. Thursday game will be at Ohio Dominican and be a 5:30 tip, 5:15 pregame. And then Saturday, make our way over to wonderful Painesville, Ohio, just on the east side of Cleveland, and take on the Storm there. So the lights come back out and back on, rather, in Croy. Oilers in there. Traditional home white jerseys. They'll go ahead and walk out to the center stripe. Krista Putoff will jump center for the Oilers. I imagine Allie Dittmer for the Chargers. Hillsdale in their road blue jerseys. And we're just about ready to get things started. Jeffrey Klaus will toss it up. And ball is in the air. Oilers win the tap. Comes back to Carly Boner, and she'll send it over to Horseman. We'll get things started. Right point, Allie Toby. Toby dumped down low inside of the block, then back out to Boner, right side of the floor. She'll dribble out of pressure, go left point, then the other corner to Horseman. Horseman around the screen, gets inside, driving the paint, picks it up, kick out Hintz. Hintz gets to the foul line, reverse pivot, cut off. Now she'll step back, throw up the right-handed jumper. That's off the mark. Rebound comes to the Chargers. They want to run. Quickly ahead to Blair. Blair stop, pop with the left hand, throw it up, and rattles home. Hit every part of the rim that time, and Hillsdale takes the early 2-0 lead. Back we go the other way. Here's Toby, right point to Hintz. Hintz trying to go inside and does to Krista. Krista turn face, now put on the floor. Throw it up with the left hand, got it swatted away by Dittmer. Here come the Chargers again. This is Maddie Reed with it. Kick out to the baseline to Ott. Her three-point jumper is good. 5-0 run to start things off here for the Chargers. Just a minute underway here from Croy. Toby, right side of the floor, hand back to Boner. Boner then back top of the key. Now she'll go ahead and launch a long-range shot. That's off the back iron. Krista put off with an offensive rebound. Throw it up with the left hand. Bucket's good. Nice move that time underneath by Krista. Got her man up in the air and able to get the left-handed layup to go. Oilers now on the board, trail by 3, 5-2. Dwyer, dribble left side, right in front of our broadcast booth. Now come in to the foul line, reverse out, go to the baseline, then get it back top of the key. Go right side this time to Ott. Ott then into the corner to Reed, then back out to Dittmer. She'll take the shot just inside the three-point line. Bucket's good. Hillsdale yet to miss a shot here and lead by 5, 7-2. Here comes Toby, crossover dribble, drive. 20 on the shot clock for the Oilers. Haley driving the paint, a lot of contact, no whistle. Go to the baseline and send it inside. Krista got away with a double dribble. Now she'll throw it to the left hand. Bucket's good.
By 3 points against the Chargers. 7-4 is the score. Dwyer will shoot the three ball on the right wing. Ball will go out of bounds. And it's going to be an inbounds pass for Hintz. Hintz gets it in. Toby.
Top of the key with it to put off. Left point Hintz. Anna looking over the defense, trying to go inside. Not there. Cross court pass nearly stolen away. Goes out of bounds. And it'll stay right here with the Oilers. As Dwyer tried to get a hand on it that time, knocked it away.
Toby.
Just couldn't corral it.
Almost gets taken away by the Chargers. 7:33 remains in the first period.
I'm just doing this, Nick, to get acclimated.
Dwyer with the ball at the top of the key. She's going to drive, gives off to Dittmer. Dittmer will try to drive, but she'll shoot the little jumper. Goes off the rim. Rebound comes away to Horseman. Horseman trying to drive at the top. She's going to go with the left side. Stops her momentum. Throws it across to Carly Boner. Now back up top to Hintz. Hintz looking down low to put off, put off. Backing down Dittmer and has to stop. Uses her pivot foot, and they're going to call a 3-second violation against Putoff, and that will be a change of possession. We'll have some substitutions for both for the Oilers. They'll bring in Alyssa Ellerbrick. They'll bring in Jenna Stegmeier. And they'll also bring in Lindsay Engelbrecht. Inbounds pass to Dwyer. Oilers trying to figure out this Chargers team. Early minutes, 6:46 remains in this first period. Dwyer at top, gives off to Dittmer, back to Dwyer. Now swings it over to Ott. Ott driving baseline, throws it back out on the left side for the three ball by Blair and drains it. Makes a 10-4, a 6-point lead for the Chargers. Engelbrecht tried to go to the basket, gets the ball taken away. With the ball currently right now, Ott. Ott gives off to the back for another three ball at the top, and that is missed by Brittany Gray. Wanting transition is Toby. Toby gives off to Ellerbrock in the corner. Can't finish it off. At the top is Ott. Ott gives off to Dwyer. Dwyer, mainly the sole key for this offense for Hillsdale, trying to make plays happen. The ball just rolls around the rim. No good. Rebound does come away to the Oilers. Once again, from that same spot, but different player this time. Jenna Stegmeier with the three ball. 3-point lead for the Chargers. Makes it 10-7. 5:30 left in the first. Dwyer. Dwyer looking down low to Dittmer. Dittmer getting double teamed, throws it back up top. Another three ball being put up by Gray, and Gray sinks the three. Makes the score 13-7 with 5:10. Put off. Over to Stegmeier. Stegmeier wants to drive up the lane, go with the right hand, can't finish it off, too hard on the glass. Rebound comes away to the Chargers. Dwyer with the transition. Dwyer driving, has to stop, gives off. Gives off to Blair. Blair trying to get it back to Dwyer, and it goes out of bounds. Substitutions come in for the Oilers and Chargers, but that is the media timeout. We'll take a short break. You are watching UFTV.
Are you struggling with an opiate addiction and pregnant? We know it can be scary to ask for help when you don't know how others will treat you when you reach out. You are not alone, and there is help available for you and your baby. A treatment and recovery resource guide is available that can provide valuable information. Please call 419-424-1985 to receive a free copy of the resource guide, sponsored by the Hancock County Board of Alcohol, Drug Addiction, and Mental Health Services.
Wasbo Rental Property is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio and its surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to thesshermanhouse.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbo is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
And welcome back out. That was a media timeout for both sides. It's been an interesting first period for both teams, but the Chargers definitely making their presence heard behind the arc, drinking a lot of three balls, and kind of working the offense for the Chargers is Dwyer. She gets a little bit of a break. She's now on the bench for the Chargers. Substitutions did come in during that media timeout for both sides. And currently with the ball is Bree Porter. Porter at the top, looking down low to Wacker. And a foul is called. It's going to be against the Oilers. And that's Hintz's first foul. 13-7, still the score to 4:38 left. Reed gives off to Porter. Now looking, Reed, and working that perimeter once again. Reed gets her own rebound, tries to put it back up and in. Hintz trying to fight for the ball. It's probably what looks like it was going to be a jump ball, and definitely will be a jump ball, but the possession arrow is pointing towards the Chargers.
Chargers substitution 52.
Charges with substitutions. They bring back in Dittmer, and they also bring back in Dwyer. Hintz comes out of the game for a breather. Putoff comes in for the Oilers as well. Dwyer gives off to Ott for the three ball on the left wing. Can't finish it off. Rebound comes away to Horseman. 4:05 left. Horseman at the top. Wants to drive. Gets the ball knocked out of her hands. And wanting the transition is Reed. Reed trying to drive, gives off to his other player, which is Gray, and Gray gets the easy lay and makes it 15-7. Quick transition by the Chargers. Ellerbrock gives off the Horseman now. Gives off the putoff. Putoff getting double teamed. And the Chargers just swarming the ball right now down low. And the Oilers having to use the perimeter. The Chargers are saying, hey, you got to get the 3-point shot now. You can't go down low with your two bigs. A nice transition there by the Oilers on defense to get that stop. Horseman at top, 3:16 left, 15-7 Chargers on top of the Oilers. Going for the nice jumper there was Ellerbrock, and Ellerbrock can't make it, but the ball does go out of bounds. Substitutions, Boner comes back in for the Oilers, and for the Chargers they bring in Blair and Degree. Horseman with the inbounds pass, gets it into Ellerbrock for the three ball on the left side. Can't finish it off, gets her own rebound, tries to get it to put off, fumbles the ball, ends up in Chargers' hands, driving with the ball. As Blair has to give it off to Dwyer for that short little jumper towards the elbow, can't finish it off. Rebound comes away to the Oilers. Horseman driving on that left side, going for the lay-in, can't. Ball sails over the rim, but gets her own rebound. Nice job staying on that baseline. Gives off to Carly Boner at the top. Can't finish the three. Ball sails out of bounds. Last touch by Dwyer, and that will be Oilers ball. Substitutions come in for the Oilers. They bring in Toby and Ellerbrock. Well, actually, excuse me, Stegmeyer. Toby gives off to Frick. Stegmeyer. Going down low to Putoff. Driving baseline. Go reverse it. Get the and one. She'll go to the line to shoot one free throw to try to get the three-point play. 2:14 left in the first period. 15-9. Chargers still on top of the Oilers. Makes the free throw, so that's a three-point play for the Oilers. Trying to get back into this one. It's only down by 5 points in the first period. And once again, those Chargers working the perimeter and also looking down low to Dwyer, trying to back down, trying to work on that baseline, and the Oilers doing a good job of keeping them away from that basket. Air ball there by the Chargers. By Reed, and rebound comes away to the Oilers. Carly Boner gives off to Frick, and a foul will be called against the Chargers. We'll see who it's against, and it's going to be against Dittmer. And that will be Dittmer's second foul. Substitutions come in for both for the Chargers. We'll take Dittmer out with those two fouls. Inbounds pass, gets it in, a nice job, and it was wide open for Stegmeyer. Couldn't finish it off on that right side. And an easy three ball again for the Chargers, McKenna Ott. And it's 18-10 now with a minute 20 left in the first period. At the top is Toby. Toby gives off the Boner. Boner looked down low to Toby, calling for it on the left side, doesn't have to roll back out in the corner. Put off, throws it back up top to Frick. Frick now over to Boner. Gives off to Stegmeyer. Stegmeyer getting guarded heavily by the Chargers. Wants to go baseline with the right side. Goes all the way. It gets the basket up and in. And good. 18-12 with 54 seconds left in the first period. Chargers. Dwyer wants to drive on the left. Stops her momentum towards that free throw line. Will throw it up. And could not get it. Put off trying to come away with the rebound. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. And a good eye by the referee to call that one Oilers ball. Put off comes out. Looks like a wrestling match out there right now, folks. And Jim Weedy on the sideline laughing about it. Toby. Over to Boner, now back up top to Frick. Frick looking down low, two hints, and that will be a kick ball against the Chargers on Ott. 24.3 seconds left, 18-12. Oilers still down against the Chargers. Looking for the inbounds pass, does get it into Stegmeier. Stegmeier gives off to Hintz at the top. And Toby trying to go for that back door, goes down low to Stegmeier on the left side, throws it back up top for the jumper for Hintz. Can't finish it off, rebound comes away to Porter. Porter wants to drive and a nice job, oh! And I don't know about that one, folks. Toby had the feet set and they're gonna call the blocking call instead of the charge. What do you have to notice if folks at home watching this or watching this on YouTube currently live? Oilers women definitely trying to step their game up against this Chargers team. 2 seconds left and Porter tries to shoot the three but can't get it off in time. The score in the first period at the end, 18-12 in the first period. We're going to go into the second with a new set of 10 minutes on the clock. You are listening and watching Oilers basketball here on UFTV.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Get some drinks.
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine.
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go and step out of the vehicle for me.
I'm Jenny Garth. And as a mother of three, I know kids worry about a lot of things. Getting enough food to eat shouldn't be one of them. But here in America, that is a real worry for 1 in 5 children. This is unacceptable and something Feeding America is working to solve. Through a nationwide network of food banks, Feeding America serves virtually every community in the United States, including yours. See how you can help your community. Visit feedingamerica.org. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're Feeding America.
Wasbo Rental Property is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio and its surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to thesherman.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbo is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
Out of that break, Oilers trying to get into that rhythm, and they definitely did towards the end. Chargers not really knowing what they're doing, and right now, Chargers playing a 2-1-2 defense against the Oilers. And in the game, it's Lindsey Engelbrecht, and that's going to be a turnover for the Oilers. Chargers come away with that one, and Gray wants transition, but stops her momentum at the top. Gives off to Blair. Blair at the top, calling for it right now is Ott. Ott will shoot the three ball. Can't finish that off, hits the rim. And it's no good, a foul will be called. It's gonna be a push off. Nice job there by Toby to sacrifice her body going out of bounds. And that's the team's first foul in the second period. So we're still 18-12. Hintz at the top. Gives off the Frick, now over to Toby on the right wing. Looking down low to Hintz. Hintz tried to drive baseline, wasn't a good idea. Has to throw it back up top to Engelbrecht. Now Toby with it, still looking to Hintz, but not going to her. Throws it back up top to Stegmeier. And now driving is Eller Brock, and that is no good. 8:48 left in the second period. And that was a big throw by Dwyer. That goes right out of bounds. And that will be Oilers' ball. Toby gives off to Eller Brock. Eller Brock will shoot the three ball on the right side and splashes it down. No one was on her in sight. You would need a telescope to see the defender. Blair brings the ball back up top. Now gives over to Gray. Gray over to Dwyer on the right wing. Dwyer gives off to Wacker. Wacker back over to Blair. Blair can't finish it off. The rebound comes away to the Oilers. Oilers want transition. And that is Stegmeier trying to drive, gives off to Eller Brock. Eller Brock now over to Engelbrecht. And that's Fricky who finishes it off with the three ball. And now we're all tied up, folks. 18-18 with 7:37 left in the second period. Ott will shoot the three ball and sinks it. So back to a three-point lead, 21-18 Chargers. Back on top. We were only tied for maybe about 5 seconds. Engelbrecht at the top. Chargers showing a 2-3 defense right now. Driving is Stegmeier. Going down low to Fricke, and Fricke will shoot the jumper. Can't finish it off. It hits the tip of the rim. Rebound comes away to the Chargers. And another three ball by Gray. And threes are sinking from this Chargers defense, either from the starters or from the bench players. Toby gives off to Stegmeier. Stegmeier getting double teamed, trying to find somebody, and that double team's working for the Chargers. They come away with another turnover. Dwyer wants to drive on the right side, stops, throws it back up top. Going down low to Ott. Ott gets the basket, and a timeout has to be called by the Oilers. 26-18. It's a full timeout. 26-18. We'll take the timeout. Media timeout. We'll take the timeout with them. You are watching women's basketball here on UFTV.
Enter the Oilers Dream Vacation Raffle.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Some drinks.
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine.
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go and step out of the vehicle for me.
See ya, buddy. Good luck.
So turns out, buzz driving and drunk driving, they're the same thing. And it costs around $10,000. So not worth it.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Because they understand that I work hard for my money and deserve a reward, like Everyday Rewards Checking, a checking account that rewards you with a refund on your ATM charges. Plus, you can get paid cash rewards or great interest rate rewards just for using your debit card or paying a bill online, right from your phone or tablet. Stop by the Union Bank today and ask about Everyday Rewards Checking, or visit us online, your community bank.
Union Bank.
Member FDIC.
All right, well, that was actually a media timeout. They were making it look like it was going to be a 30-second timeout. Instead, they used it as the media timeout. Gives them a little bit extra time to prep out of that break. Oilers with the ball, losing right now 26-18, and Hillsdale really using that arc against the Oilers, and they're trying their best to defend. Boner gives off to Toby, now down low to Putoff. Putoff will drive with the left hand and can finish it off, down by 6 points against the Chargers with 5:50 left in the second period. Porter going down low, does get it off the Wacker, and Wacker finishes it off with 2 points. Back to an 8-point lead for the Chargers. 5:39 left in the second period. We're gonna see a substitution by the Oilers on the next dead ball. Horseman will come back in, as well as Hintz. Boner at the top. Zone defense being shown again by the Chargers. Fricke goes down low to Putoff. Putoff, nice job using the body, swinging it over on the left side, and gets the easy lay-in, makes it 28-22. Porter across that timeline. Gives off to Reed, back up top. Porter over to Blair. Porter working the perimeter. Back up top to Wacker. Wacker can't finish off the three ball. Bounces right off the rim. Rebound does come away to the Oilers. Driving all the way to the basket. A nice job there by Alyssa Ellerbrock to try to break that zone defense and drive to the basket. and gets fouled while doing it, so she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Alyssa Ellicott shooting two.
28-22, 4:41 left in the second. First free throw up and good. Substitutions come in for both sides. So like I said, Hintz comes in, Horseman comes in. For Hillsdale, Dwyer comes back in, as well as Degree, and also McKenna Ott for the Chargers. Makes the second free throw. With the ball, Morgan Blair. Blair gives off to Degree. And Degree gets the 2 points, makes it 30-24. Horseman gives off to Boner. Now over to Hintz, Hintz at the top. Boner. Back up top to Ellerbrock. Down to Putoff. Putoff can't finish it off. Still remains 30-24. Dwyer. Once again, trying to work the Oilers' defense, and doesn't work out again for him. And Jessica DeGreer goes right to the basket again. She has 4 points. Makes the score 32-24. Horseman up top to Hintz. Now looking down low to Putoff. Putoff will shoot the jumper. Trying to go right over a defender. Instead, it bounces off the glass and is no good. Dwyer comes away with the rebound. Dwyer stops her momentum at the free throw line. Driving baseline, wide open in the corner. No one on her in sight. Can't finish it off. That was Morgan Blair. And they still get 2 points. So a 10-point lead for the Chargers. And right now, Maddie Reed, she got those points for them. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. Oilers ball substitution come in. Stegmeyer comes in for the Oilers. Brittany Gray comes in for the Chargers, as well as Sydney Anderson. Oilers get it in off the baseline. Back up top to Hintz. Now over to Ellerbrock at the top. Carly Boner in that corner. Hintz trying to call for it down low. Horseman will drive with the right hand and get it up and in and good. So score now 34-26. Going down low once again for the Chargers, trying to get it to Gray. Now Dwyer will shoot the jumper, and Dwyer. She gets her first points of the game, but has been running this offense pretty smoothly for the Chargers. Stegmeyer gives off to Boner. Boner trying to work baseline, but we'll bring it back up. Moves her pivot foot, and that's a travel. Substitutions will come back in for the Oilers. And a lot of rotations being shown by Coach Weedy. A lot of rotations. Sometimes those are good decisions, but sometimes those can be harmful. Minute 53 left in the second. Hint on Degree, and a foul would be called against Degree. That's her first foul. Oh, they call it travel. Called it a travel. Looking down low to Hintz. Hintz gets it off. She'll shoot the jumper on the right side and finish it off. 36-28 is the score. A minute 27 left in the second period. And the Oilers going with a man-to-man defense really strictly against the Chargers, and shooting that jumper is Engelbrecht, and Engelbrecht finishes it off. 6-point lead now for the Chargers. Oilers trying to regain this lead. Minute left in the second period before we hit half. Anderson gets the ball taken away from him. Horseman wants to drive. She wants to drive to the basket with the right hand and finishes it off. Bounces it off the backboard and in for 2 points. Makes it 36-32. That hypes the bench for the Oilers. 40 seconds left. Gray gives up top to Ott. Ott over to Dwyer. Dwyer will shoot the jumper and rolls around and will go right in. Makes the score 38-32. 23 seconds remain, and the Oilers right now just want to play for the last shot before halftime. Toby gives off to Engelbrecht. Engelbrecht over to Stagmeier for the three ball. Can't finish it off. Ball gets knocked out of bounds with 6 seconds left. And the Oilers will keep the ball. Substitutions will come in for the Hillsdale Chargers. Six seconds left. Toby with the inbounds pass. Someone has to break away. And Engelbrecht finishes it off on the right corner. And it's 38-35 going into halftime. Gets that nice three ball off. And the Oilers only being down by 3 points, having a struggle in this first half. But they're keeping the win in sights right now, being only down by 3 points. It's going to be an interesting second half. We'll be right back. You are watching Oilers basketball here on UFTV.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Wasbo Rental Property is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio, and the surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to theshermanhouse.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbro is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
Ohio Logistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
Outdoor pool. You can reach Drury Inn and Suites online at druryhotels.com, or you can contact them by calling the Findlay location at 419-422-9700. Drury Inn and Suites in Findlay is a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Sports on 88.3 WLFC.
University of Findlay Athletics is sustained on 88.3 WLFC by Frickers. Frickers is located at exit 157 off of Interstate 75 in Findlay, featuring wings, burgers, and sports on every TV. You can contact Frickers by calling 419-423-9464. Frickers is also on the web at frickers.com. Frickers, just off of I-75 and State Route 12, a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Sports on 88.3 WLFC.
Jimmy John's in Findlay serves subs baked on bread baked in-house every day. Serving single sandwiches and party platters, Jimmy John's is located at 536 Trenton Avenue in Findlay. If you don't want to get off the couch, you can also order online at www.jimmyjohns.com or through the Jimmy John's mobile app for your smartphone. Jimmy John's, proudly underwriting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Keats Dugout at 3112 North Main Street in Findlay is happy to support Oiler Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Keats Dugout provides lunches to go, and the menu features items like breaded and shredded chicken, coney dogs, and more. Keats Dugout can be reached by calling 419-423-7911. That's 419-423-7911. Keats Dugout, a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
We're at halftime with the Lady Oilers trailing Hillsdale 38-35.
This is Ron Knopf in the 88.3 WLFC studios with your Oilers basketball halftime report. Lady Oilers were down a little bit there, made a comeback towards the end of the second quarter. Krista Putoff led the way for the Lady Oilers with 11 points, also 3 rebounds. Lindsay Engelbrecht contributed 8 points. Jenna Stegmeier kicked in 5, Haley Horstman with 4, Dana Fricke with 3, Anna Hintz and Alyssa Ellerbrock with 2 apiece. At the end of the half, end of halftime, Jason Granger will have all your stats and analysis. Now, let's take a brief timeout and get a news update from our friends at FSN.
News in Washington, I'm Rebecca Foster. U.S. officials are trying to downplay possible cracks emerging in the U.S.-Australia relationship following what President Trump called the worst call ever with Prime Minister Turnbull. This while the president himself is blaming the former Obama administration for what Trump's called a dumb deal to bring 1,200 refugees into the U.S.
I love Australia as a country, but we had a problem where, for whatever reason, President Obama said that they were going to take probably well over 1,000 illegal immigrants who were in prisons, and they were going to bring them and take them into this country. And I just said, why? I just wanted to ask a question. I can ask that question of you, why? 1,250, could be 2,000, could be more than that. And I said, why? Why are we doing this? What's the purpose?
Why do I choose Union Bank? Convenience. At work, home, or out and about. I can check my balance from my smartphone, laptop, or tablet, and even deposit a check. I'll find convenient locations all across the region with a staff who cares from my community and a great network of ATMs, so there's always one close by. Visit theubank.com and see just how convenient your community bank is for you. Thank you, Omar. Union Bank. Member FDIC.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Because they understand that I work hard for my money and deserve a reward, like Everyday Rewards Checking, a checking account that rewards you with a refund on your ATM charges. Plus, you can get paid cash rewards or great interest rate rewards just for using your debit card or paying a bill online, right from your phone or tablet. Stop by the Union Bank today and ask about Everyday Rewards Checking or visit us online, your community bank. Union Bank. Member FDIC.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
...with Brussels by the end of March.
From Euros Worldwide, this is FSN.
When we come back, we'll take a look at what's happening in the GLIAC and Division I Women's Top 25 and get an update on your 419 weather. You're listening to the Oilers Basketball Halftime Report on 88.3 WLFC.
Kirk Chiropractic is committed to your health and wellness and is happy to support University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Kirk Chiropractic may be able to relieve your tension headaches through chiropractic care. You can reach Kirk Chiropractic at kirkchiro.com. That's Kirk, C-H-I-R-O.com, or by calling 419-425-9798. Located at 116 West Lima Avenue in Findlay, Kirk Chiropractic is a proud sponsor of the Orange and Black on 88.3 WLFC.
Oiler Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is underwritten in part by KT Equipment Rental. Located at 835 Western Avenue in Findlay, KT Equipment Rental has been your locally owned and operated rental service for over 45 years. KT Equipment Rental is your local dealer for steel outdoor power equipment. They can be reached at 419-422-4549. You can also go online to ktequipmentrental.com. KT Equipment Rental, a proud sponsor of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Outback Steakhouse is proud to bring you Oiler Sports on 88.3 WLFC. Featuring a menu with steaks, seafood, and more, Outback Steakhouse is located at 930 Interstate Drive in Findlay. Carryout service is available as well. You can reach Outback Steakhouse at 419-424-1510 or by using their mobile app on your smartphone. Outback Steakhouse at 930 Interstate Drive in Findlay, just off of US 224, is a proud underwriter of the University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Oiler Sports on 88.3 WLFC is underwritten in part by Steiner & Granger, located at 141 North Main Street in Bluffton. Steiner & Granger can assist you in a financial strategy for your retirement, from mutual funds to annuities to life insurance. Steiner & Granger can be reached at 419-358-0689 or online at steinerandgranger.com. Securities offered through Sage Point Financial Incorporated, member FINRA, SIPC. Insurance services offered through Steiner & Granger, who is not affiliated with Sage Point Financial Incorporated.
Welcome back. We're at halftime with the Lady Oilers trailing Hillsdale 38-35. This is Ron Kanoff in the 88.3 WLFC studios with more of your Oiler basketball halftime report. Taking a look at your women's GLIAC scoreboard down in Columbus, Ohio, Dominican hosting the number one team in the country, Ashland. Eagles and Panthers. Eagles getting all they can handle from the Panthers. Only lead 35-23. They're at the half there. Tiffin and Lake Erie, another competitive game, tied 33 at the half. With just under a minute to go in the second quarter, it's Grand Valley State at Wayne State, and the Lakers lead the Warriors 32-17. With just under 4 minutes to go in the first quarter, Michigan Tech at Northwood, Huskies lead 17-11. Just over 3 minutes to go, first quarter, Saginaw Valley at Ferris State, Cardinals up 13-11. Coming up at 7 o'clock tonight, it'll be Northern Michigan at Lake Superior State. Taking a look at women's Division I top 25 games, full slate tonight. Coming up at 7 o'clock, number 4, South Carolina at number 25, Kentucky. It'll be number 6, Florida State visiting Boston College. Clemson at number 15, Duke. Number 19, NC State at number 9, Louisville. It'll be Pittsburgh visiting number 24, Syracuse. Number 7, Notre Dame at Virginia Tech. Number 16, Miami of Florida at Wake Forest. It'll be number 21, Green Bay from the Horizon League at Oakland. At 8 o'clock, number 3, Maryland at Purdue. And 9 o'clock tonight, number 5, Mississippi State at Auburn. Taking a look at your 419 area forecast, calling for partly cloudy skies through the overnight. It'll be a little bit cooler with a low of 13. Friday starts off with cloudy skies before becoming mostly sunny for majority of the day. Our high will top out at 28, we'll have a low of 12. And the weekend starts off with increasing cloudiness before snow blows in through the overnight. Accumulation of half an inch is possible. The high will be 30, we'll have a low of 24. Currently in the 419 area, we have overcast skies and 27 degrees. After a short break, we'll get you back out to the Croy Center, where Jason will have analysis and stats of all the action from the first half. Findlay trails Hillsdale 38-35. You're listening to the Oiler Basketball Halftime Report on 88.3 WLFC.
Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is brought to you in part by Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic, located at 1930 North Main Street in Findlay. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is an animal hospital that provides a range of services for your pet. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. till 6 p.m. and on Saturdays from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. You can call them at 419-422-3292. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics. Oiler Sports on 88.3 WLFC is a service of Bliss Charters in Fostoria. Bliss Charters provides motor coach services to groups of all sizes. Bliss Charters drivers are trained professionals who exceed standards set by Ohio Department of Transportation standards. You can find Bliss Charters online at www.blisscharters.net. You can also reach Bliss by calling 419-435-7144. Bliss Charters is a proud sponsor of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
University of Findlay Sports is brought to you on 88.3 WLFC in part by City Barbecue on Flag City Drive in Findlay. City Barbecue Catering can cook for groups of all sizes and can handle your special requests. You can find City Barbecue at 15033 Flag City Drive in front of Menards. You can reach them by calling 419-422-200 or find them online at citybarbecue.com. City Barbecue, a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Dick's Auto Supply is a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Dick's Auto Supply can be found in two locations, in Findlay at 349 Midland Avenue and in Fostoria at 601 Plaza Drive. Dick's Auto Supply provides a selection of parts and accessories for your vehicle. You can reach Dick's Auto Supply by calling 800-682-1419 or online at dicksautosupplyinc.com. Dick's Auto Supply, supporting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
This is your radio home for Lady Oiler Basketball, 88.3 WLFC.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Opportunity now to take a look at the stats. Oilers trail Hillsdale 38-35, but really a nice job at the end of that second quarter to really erase that 10-point deficit, get it down to just a three here at the half. We'll start out with Hillsdale. They're led by Brittany Gray off the bench. 4-7 from the floor, 3-4 from downtown. She's got 11 points. McKenna Ott, 3-4 from the floor, 2-3 from three-point range. 8 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists. Allie Dittmer just played 9 minutes. She was in foul trouble almost the entire first half. She had 2 points. Morgan Blair, 5 points on 2-4 shooting. Allie DeWire, 2-7 from the floor, 4 points, 2 rebounds. Other scoring off the bench for Hillsdale. Julia Wacker, 1-3 from the floor, 2 points and a rebound. And Jessica DeGree, 2-2 from the floor, 4 points, a rebound, played 6 minutes. Hillsdale in that first half, 16-32, that's 50%. 6-12 from downtown for 50%, did not take a foul shot. Oilers led by the sophomore, Krista Putoff, 5-8 shooting, 11 points, 3 rebounds, played 13 minutes, and hence 2 points on 1-3 shooting. Haley Horseman is 2-4 from the floor, 4 points, 3 rebounds. Allie Toby played 15 minutes, did not score, had 3 boards and 2 assists. Carly Boner struggled in that first half, just 2 shot attempts, did not score. Lindsay Engelbrecht, 3-5 from the floor, 2-3 from 3-point range, 8 points, 2 assists. Lissa Ellenbrock played 8 minutes, had 2 points, both those coming from the foul line. Dana Fricke played 8 minutes, 1-2 from the floor, including a 3-pointer. Had 3 points, 2 rebounds. And Jenna Stagmeyer, 2-5 from the floor, 1-2 from downtown, 5 points, 4 rebounds. Finley in that first half, 14-32, okay. 44%.
And welcome back out to Croy Gymnasium, where halftime winding down and the start of the second half begins. 38-35, Chargers on top. It's going to be an interesting second half. And the question I worry about for the Oilers for tonight's game is the rotation they have right now. A lot of rotations being spewed out by the Oilers. It's not allowing the team to get acclimated to this Chargers offense and defense. And you just got to be careful in those situations. You got to let the team know the player they're going up against and how they play. And right now the Chargers are manipulating that three-point line and getting easy threes. But the Oilers will try to fight back while being only down by 3 points. Toby gives off the Horseman on the right over to Boner. Getting double-teamed, throws it back up top to Toby. Back to Horseman. Look baseline for Hintz, but we'll bring it back up top. Zone defense being shown by the Chargers. Kick ball by DeWire. Inbounds pass by Hintz. Gets it in to Toby. Boner back to Tony. Looking baseline. Boner will drive. Goes down low to Putoff, and that wasn't a good pass. And time, it's going to be a clock. Clock will expire, so shot clock violation against the Oilers. And Chargers will get the ball. And now they're kind of showing a little bit of a pressure at that timeline against DeWire, and that leaves a wide open Ott in the corner. Three's no good. Horseman comes away with the rebound. She wants to drive, but gives off to Toby. Driving's put off, a nice job. Goes with the left hand and puts it up and in for the 2 points. Now only down by one. At one point, they were tied. until the Chargers got another three ball and then started expanding their lead again. Looking down low to Dittmer, they don't. They throw it back up top to Blair. Blair drives on baseline, throws it across for a three ball for Dwyer. That's an air ball and tipped out of bounds. Last touch by the Oilers. It was on Hintz. And the Chargers will get the ball back. And I'm not quite sure. I think the referees right now are trying to figure out who touched it last. And they're going to keep it with the Chargers. And I think they have the right call. Hintz did have her hand on the ball last. And a nice pass by Blair to Ott for the 2 points. Going for that kind of alley-oop type of pass. Hintz will shoot the jumper, and Hintz drains it. Score now 40-39, only down by 1 point for the Oilers. Trying to get that pressure on Dwyer by the Oilers, and Dwyer's just breaking it right away, trying to drive baseline. Goes out of bounds, and that will be Oilers ball. Nice job there by Toby to keep the pressure up, keep the hands up, and not lean the body into the player, because you get some fouls called by the referees on that. Toby with the ball. Wide open lane with the left side and gets it right in. 41-40, first lead for the Oilers. And we'll see if tempo changes. Defense has to get back. Double teamed by Putoff and also Toby, and a nice job there to get the rebound. Foul is going to got to be called, and it will be called. Wrapped around by Blair. Substitution will come in for the Oilers. They'll bring back in Engelbrecht, and coming out will be Carly Boner. Toby. 7:19 left, first lead for the Oilers. At the top is Putoff. Putoff brings it over to the right side. Now Toby back at the top of the key. Back over to Hintz on the left side. Looking down low to Putoff. Can't go to her. And finally Toby does go to her. Gets double teamed, throws it back up top to Horseman. Now back over to Engelbrecht. Engelbrecht gives off to Toby. And Engelbrecht will have to shoot the three ball. Can't finish it off. Hits the rim, off the glass, into the Chargers' hands. And that was a travel. Refs didn't call it. Ball will be thrown across baseline. Fake three by Dwyer. Gives off now to Reed. Back up top to Dwyer. Nice defense being shown by the Oilers. More man-to-man defense. Dittmer gets the ball knocked out of her hands by Horseman. Horseman wants transition. Gives off to Hintz. Hintz couldn't control the pass. What a nice pass to Toby. Toby didn't have enough power to get it up and in and try to save it. Chargers come away with it, driving, and a nice jump stop to fake out the defender, and Maddie Reeder gets the 2 points. And we'll see how long the timeout is. I think they're calling it the media timeout. So the score here, 42-41. The Oilers now down against the Chargers. You are watching Oiler basketball here on UFTV.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Wasbo Rental Property is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio, and its surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to theshermanhouse.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbro is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back out to Croy Gymnasium. Media timeout currently,
before this. 1:16 left in the third period. We're coming right out of that media timeout. Both teams trying to just figure out some type of tempo. A lot of fast-paced basketball being played by both sides. And finally, the Oilers trying to get to the basket, get those shots off. They missed some of those shots in the first half, and they're trying to get those back. They're doing a good job of that. And we'll just see. Right now, it's kind of like a really, if you're on a big sailboat, the waves are going pretty high between both sides, and we'll see which one, which ship topples. Horseman gets double teamed, gives off to Hintz. Hintz at the top, now over to Engelbrecht. Engelbrecht fakes the three, back to Putoff. Putoff drives baseline, will go reverse, goes down low, puts it up and in on the left side. And a nice job there by Putoff. 43-42, Putoff with 15 points for the Oilers. Getting guarded by Horseman. Throws it back over up top, now over to Porter. Porter throws it back up across to Blair. Blair over to Dittmer, now in the corner for Gray, and Gray sinks the three ball in the right corner. And it's 45-43, 2-point lead for the Chargers. Horseman gives off to Ellerbrock. Ellerbrock over to Hintz. Hintz gives it back to Ellerbrock at the top. Now throws it across court to Engelbrecht. Engelbrecht looking down low to put off. Instead, Horseman will shoot that jumper. Can't finish it off, ball goes in and out, and will sail out of bounds. And a nice job. Nice job there to stay with it by Ellerbrock, but it will bounce off a Chargers player, and it will remain Oilers ball. Substitution comes in, Hintz comes out. They'll bring in Stegmeier, and Stegmeier will inbounds this one for the Oilers. Into Horseman, 45-43, 5:06 left. Horseman gives off to Engelbrecht. Back up top to Horseman, looking down low to Putoff. Gets it down low, Dittmer honored, gets double teamed. Wide open in the left corner is Ellerbrock, can't finish it off. Ball rolls around the basket, but a foul will be called. A nice job there by Stegmeier to get that foul called, and she'll go to the line to shoot two free throws for the Oilers. Substitutions come in. And now another timeout called. So we'll take the timeout with them. You were watching Oilers basketball on UFTV.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
UFTV is your university and community TV station.
All right, welcome back out of this timeout. Shooting two free throws will be Stegmeier for the Oilers. Try to tie this one up. And definitely the aggressiveness is coming out of this women's basketball team, trying to match this Chargers team all around. The Chargers, the Hillsdale Chargers, definitely brought their game today at Croy.
Stegmeier
at the line. This is the first free throw. Oilers haven't been to the line a lot through this whole game, but Stegmeier splits them and makes it 45-44, 1-point lead for the Chargers. And once again, pressure defense being shown by the Oilers, and a nice job to disrupt Dittmer's shot, and the Oilers coming away with the rebound. Stegmeier will shoot the little jumper and drains it! Makes it 46-45. Oilers back on top, and Ellerbrock trying to get that ball knocked out of the Chargers' hand. Almost got a turnover for the Oilers. And in the corner for another three ball for the Chargers. Instead, the ball gets knocked out of Dittmer's hands by Stegmeier. In the corners, Ellerbrock. Ellerbrock getting guarded by Ott. Back up top. to Toby. Now over to Engelbrecht. Engelbrecht will drive up the lane. Nice job there to get the pass off to Stegmeier. And now Toby will drain the three ball on the right side. And now it's 49-45, Oilers' largest lead against the Chargers. And you shoot a three, I'll shoot a three. Right back at the Oilers, but the Oilers remain with a one-point lead, 49-48. And driving to the basket once again was Toby. Couldn't finish it off with the left hand. Chargers come away with the rebound. Going for that little jumper by Gray. Can't finish it off. Ball sails out of bounds. Will be Oilers ball. Substitutions coming by both teams. Hintz will come back in, as well as Horseman and Boner. Blair gets the inbounds pass into her teammate. Rebound does come away with the Chargers. And putting it back up and in is Degree. And they got to be careful with Degree. The last time she was in, she got a lot of boards and putbacks against the Oilers. Boner brings it back up top. Now over to Stegmeier. A nice pick there by Hintz. Horseman back over to Stegmeier. Over to Ellebrock in the corner. Trying to go baseline, brings it back up top. Now she'll drive, take the hole, gets denied. Down low, ball will go out of bounds. Last touch by the Oilers, and it will be Chargers ball. 2:53 left in the third period. Chargers on top of the Oilers, 50-49. Dwyer gets across the timeline, throws it over to Blair. Back to Dwyer. Over to Degree. And Dwyer will shoot that jumper, and Dwyer will drain that jumper. Makes it 52-49. Horseman off to Ellerbrock. Ellerbrock gives off to Stegmeier. Stegmeier over to Boner. Back up top to Horseman. Zub defense being shown again by the Chargers, and it doesn't matter because Garlic Boner drains that three ball for the Oilers. Makes it 52-52, we're all tied up. Degree drives, throws it to Blair, can't finish off that three. Rebound, trying to come away to someone, and a nice job by Ellerbrock to get that off to Boner. Boner on the right, throws it over to Ellerbrock. Over to Horseman. Horseman will shoot the three as well, and Horseman drains the three ball on the left wing. And now it's 55-52. Horseman with 7 points. Dwyer getting double teamed. And a nice shot by Horseman trying to get that ball. Shooting the jumper is Dwyer. Rebound comes away, but they're going to call a foul on the court. Going to go against the Oilers, and it's going to go against Horseman. That's Horseman's first foul. Substitution comes in. Ellerbrock comes out. They'll bring back in Toby. Minute 16 left in the third period. And miscommunication by the Chargers, and that will be a turnover. Stegmeier with the inbounds pass to Toby. Horseman looking down low to Hintz. Hintz trying to back down her defender. Nice job with a little fake and scooping around. Gets it in on the left side, and a nice job there. 57-52, 5-point lead for the Oilers. Chargers having difficulty, and Dwyer loses control of the ball, and it goes out of bounds. It will be Oilers ball. Once again, 56.7 seconds remains in the third period. Oilers get it across the timeline. I don't know where Toby was throwing that one. Chargers take it away. Wide open on that wing. It is Ott, and Ott takes the chance and makes the three ball, makes it 57-55. Toby, once again, is going to get double teamed. Tries to get it off. Luckily, she gets it to Stegmeier. Instead, a foul will be called against Wacker.
Hillsdale foul 30, Julio Wacker.
Ball will be taken out of bounds, not even close to bonus. Not a lot of fouls being called in this one.
Checker substitution 34, Manny Reed.
Stegmeier with the inbounds pass. Gets it into Toby. 32 seconds left. Stegmeier at the top. Gives off to Horseman. She wants to drive baseline with the left. Can't finish it off. Gives to Hintz. Hintz can't get it. And now Horseman comes away with it. She got hit in the face. She got poked in the eye, and the referee didn't even call it. It was a foul. But the Oilers will keep the ball. Horseman gets the inbounds. Up top to Hintz. Now over to Toby on the right. Horseman gives off the boner. Now to Hintz in the corner on the left. Can't finish it off. Rebound comes away to Toby. She's got to get it off with one, and she can't get it off the glass. It hits the side of the board, and that will take us to the fourth period. The Oilers now on top of the Chargers, 57-55. We'll start the fourth period after this short break. You are watching Oilers basketball on UFTV.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Convenience. At work, home, or out and about. I can check my balance from my smartphone, laptop, or tablet, and even deposit a check. I'll find convenient locations all across the region with a staff who cares from my community and a great network of ATMs, so there's always one close by. Visit theubank.com and see just how convenient your community bank is for you. Thank you, Omar. Member FDIC.
Wasbo Rental Properties is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio and its surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to thesherman house.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbo is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID. UFTV is your university and community TV station.
57-55, the Oilers on top of the Hillsdale Chargers. A big, big third period by the Oilers to get back on top. And they will start off the ball to start off the fourth period. Toby wants to drive on the left side, will throw it up, and a nice job driving to the basket, sacrificing the body to get the foul, and she'll go to the line to shoot two free throws. Toby at the line to shoot two free throws. This is the first one. With the second. Makes it 58-55, three-point lead for the Oilers. Dwyer getting guarded by Horseman. Dwyer drives on the left side, can't finish it off, too hard off the glass. Rebound comes away to the Oilers. Hintz gives off to Horseman. She'll shoot the jumper towards that elbow and drains it. Makes it 60-55, five-point lead for the Oilers. 9:23 left in the fourth period. Dwyer almost lost control of the ball, gives up to Gray for a three. She's been electric behind the arc, and a foul will be called. And Dittmer will go to the line to shoot two free throws. Foul will go against Putoff. That's Putoff's first foul. This is the first free throw. Makes the second. Succeed the 56 with 9:09 left in the fourth. Engelbrecht almost loses control of the ball, regains possession. Put up, gets double teamed. Wide open on the side is Hintz and drains the jumper. 62-56. Oilers still on top of the Chargers. Gets the pass off to Ott. Now back up top to Dwyer. Looking down low to Dittmer. Dittmer trying to call for it, but nice defense being shown by Putoff. And a good job by Putoff to knock that out of bounds. It looked like it went off Dittmer's leg, but instead they'll call it Chargers ball. Substitutions come in for the Chargers. They bring in Matty Reed. Inbounds pass by Blair, does get it into Dwyer, and Hintz was there to guard that one. Nice job, foul will be called. And if this one's against Dittmer, no, they're gonna call it against Dwyer instead. If it was against Dittmer, that would be Dittmer's fourth foul. And she would probably have to go to the bench. 8:30 left. Toby at the top. Hintz will shoot the three ball, and Hintz! Nothing but net from the right wing and makes the score 65-56, the largest lead for the Oilers tonight. And Dwyer tried to get cross, instead Hillsdale has to call the timeout. And we'll see. They're going to take a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. So we'll keep it here for this 30-second timeout. And something I noticed that the Oilers are doing well is they're using their ball protection has gotten way better, and they're moving the ball around that perimeter and trying to get the. I would have to say like the holes that they're trying to get into, because if you're looking at it as zone defense, you have to try to break that down. If it's a 2-3, and I think right now that's what the Chargers are working with. And if you can break that 2-3 zone down and find that little hole, get to the basket, sacrifice your body, you might get fouled, or you might get the end one, or you just get the basket. So right now the Oilers are doing a great job of that, and also showing pressure on the defensive side, which they did not do that in the first half against Hillsdale. And if they keep on doing that against the Chargers, that will make them mess up a little bit more. Ball security will be a little bit looser for the Chargers, and that will allow more turnovers for the Oilers to get and try to add on to this score of 65-56. So 8:09 left in the fourth period. Hillsdale had to call that timeout, trying to figure out how to break down this Oilers defense right now, because they're changing it on them. So right now with the inbounds pass is Reed. Reed trying to find Dwyer, can't get it in, has to go to Dittmer. At the top is Reed. Gives off to Dwyer on the right, back to Reed. Back to Dwyer, looking down low to Dittmer. Now has to throw it back up top to Grit. Dwyer back over to Reed. Dwyer will stop at the free throw line, throw it down low to Dittmer. Dittmer tried to back down, spin move, can't finish it off. Toby, all by herself, but Conford, it's Engelbrecht in the corner for three, can't finish it off, ball goes in and out. Rebound comes away to the Chargers, but the transition is Ott. Ott gives it off to Dwyer. Dwyer getting guarded by Toby heavily, falls down, but does get the pass up to Ott. Ott air balls that one, goes out of bounds, and that will be Oilers' ball. And now you're seeing a sense of urgency from the Chargers, where they're not quite sure what they want to run on offense. A lot of confusion, some miscues as well. Brittany Gray comes in for the Chargers. Toby at the top, gives off the Horseman. Off the Hintz. Down low to Putoff. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. It will remain Oiler ball. Toby with the inbounds pass. Does get it into Engelbrecht, but wasn't ready for the pass. Ball sails out of bounds. Reed with the inbound pass to Porter. Porter at the top. over to Gray. Gray wants to drive, gets double teamed by Putoff and Engelbrecht, and instead Dittmer shoots the jumper and makes the score now 65-58 with 6:49 left in the fourth period. Horseman looking baseline to Putoff, will throw it back to Toby. Now back to Putoff on baseline and try to get it off the defender, and a nice job there by Putoff to knock it off the defender's leg, and trying to save it was Gray, but couldn't. Ball still went out of bounds anyway. Ellerbrock comes back in, as well as Stegmeier and Boner. Ellerbrock up top, the Horseman. Over to Boner. 65-58 with 6:30 left in the fourth. Boner will shoot the three ball. Can't finish it off. Rebound comes away to Putoff, and a jump ball will be called. Possession arrow pointing towards the Chargers. Substitutions will come in. Dwyer will come back in, and also Ott will come back in. Gave them a short break. Dwyer gets it over to Degree. Degree over Reed, up top to Dwyer. Degree trying to set the pick, now looking to Dittmer, but instead will go to Reed. Foot was on the line, and the ref did see it, so it's going to be 2 points. 65-60 is the score. Oilers still on top. They got to keep this lead. Horseman, nice fake, goes for the jumper, can't finish it off. Ball rolls around and pops out. Rebound comes away to the Chargers, wide open down is Reed. Reed will just take another jumper, can't finish it off. Dittmer kind of pushes off on Putoff. Nothing's called there. And now some sloppy basketball by both sides being played right now. Too fast. Got to slow the pace down. Got to work it. But instead, Putoff goes under the basket. Goes with the left hand. It gets fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two free throws. 5:27 left in the fourth period. So Putoff at the line to shoot two. She has 15 points right now. Wow, and now instead they're going to try to see who the foul was on. So they're actually looking over the footage.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Because they understand that I work hard for my money and deserve a reward, like Everyday Rewards Checking, a checking account that rewards you with a refund on your ATM charges. Plus, you can get paid cash rewards or great interest rate rewards just for using your debit card or paying a bill online, right from your phone or tablet. Stop by the Union Bank today and ask about Everyday Rewards Checking, or visit us online, your community bank. Member FDIC.
All right, shooting at the line. They were just trying to figure out, I believe, who the foul was on. And I believe it was on Dittmer, and that is her fourth foul. Put off with the first free throw, can't finish it. So she'll have another one on the way. Substitution will come in for the Oilers. Hints will come in. Misses that one, but a nice shot by Stegmeier to get the rebound. Oilers will gain possession back, and that's a turnover for the Oilers. Ellerbrock tried to get it down to Putoff, and the Chargers blocked that one. Wide open for the three ball. It was Ott, couldn't finish it off. A nice job by the Oilers to get the rebound. Horseman fakes the three, gives off the Boner in the corner on the left side. Can't finish it off. Rebound once again comes away to the Chargers by Wacker. Wacker over to Dwyer. Dwyer gives off to Blair. Blair up top to Ott. Now Dwyer with it. 4:47 left in the fourth period. Dwyer wants to drive, then goes baseline. Rolls it back around on the right wing. Has to throw it across to Gray. And they have 6 seconds left on the shot clock. Going down low, 2-1, and it's going to be Oilers ball. A nice job there by the Oilers defense to keep confusion on the Chargers offensive side.
And that's a turnover. 4:30 left in the fourth period. 65-60 with five. Ellerbrock on the left wing. Now over to Stegmeyer. Goes over to Hintz on the baseline. Now over to Ellerbrock. Ellerbrock getting guarded heavily by Blair. Horseman throws it back over to Boner. And once again, just miscues by both sides. And luckily, that got tipped by a Chargers player. And it will remain Oilers' ball. .402 left. And another shot clock violation for the Oilers. Weedy trying to get his team to get going here. Try to close this one out. You got 3:59 left. DeWire gives off to Dittmer, and Dittmer's back in. She's got to be careful. Rebound comes away to the Oilers. Dittmer working with four fouls for the Chargers. Gives off to Hintz. Hintz gets double teamed in the corner. Nice job by Ellerbrock to keep that one from getting stripped away. Hintz will shoot the jumper on the side. Can't finish it off. Rebound comes away to the Chargers. And Gray wants transition. She wants to drive. She'll put it off. But a nice shot by Engelbrecht to stay with that ball and intercept it for the Oilers. And a timeout will be called by Coach Weedy. 3 minutes, 11 seconds left. 65-60. Oilers still on top of the Chargers. You are watching Oilers basketball here on UFTV.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Are you struggling with an opiate addiction and pregnant? We know it can be scary to ask for help when you don't know how others will treat you when you reach out. You are not alone, and there is help available for you and your baby. A treatment and recovery resource guide is available that can provide valuable information. Please call 419-424-1985 to receive a free copy of the resource guide, sponsored by the Hancock County Board of Alcohol, Drug Addiction, and Mental Health Services.
.65-60, a timeout had to be called by the Oilers. Miscues being happening on the offensive side for the Oilers. And Weedy wants to try to get his team going, and Engelbrecht will shoot that jumper. And that's what they want. 67-60, 2:50 left in the fourth period. Chargers. In this situation, you want to go for the quickest basket. Don't want to go right for that three. If you go for the two, that's perfectly fine. Instead, that is a missed basket by DeWire. Rebound comes away to Horseman, and she realizes we can work the clock right now. Throws it across to Engelbrecht. Now to Stegmeyer. Over to Hintz on baseline. Throws it back up top to Engelbrecht. Engelbrecht getting double teamed. Nice job not moving that pivot foot. Gives off the Horseman. Now over to Ellerbrock, back to Hintz, driving baseline, can go with the right side, can't finish it off, but a nice shot by Stegmeyer to keep the shot clock alive, and that's a new set of time for the Oilers with 2 minutes left in the fourth period. Hintz getting double teamed in the corner on the right, has to throw it out, nice job to get it to Horseman. Horseman drives up, goes for the jumper, and gets the jumper! Makes it 69-60, a nice job by Horseman. She has 11 points on the night. Makes it 69-60, a timeout has to be called by the Chargers, and that's what the Oilers wanted. Trying to ice this team right now, coming down from this deficit. And it's going to be a full timeout. We'll take the timeout with them. You are watching Oilers basketball on UFTV.
Are you struggling with an opiate addiction and pregnant? We know it can be scary to ask for help when you don't know how others will treat you when you reach out. You are not alone, and there is help available for you and your baby. A treatment and recovery resource guide is available that can provide valuable information. Please call 419-424-1985 to receive a free copy of the resource guide, sponsored by the Hancock County Board of Alcohol, Drug Addiction, and Mental Health Services.
Wasbo Rental Properties is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio, and the surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to thesherman house.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbro is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
Welcome back out to Croy Gymnasium, 69-60. Minute 43 left in the fourth period. Dwyer at the top of the key. Zone defense being shown by the Oilers right now, and a nice job by Horseman to get that steal. And a foul will be called, and that's going to be on Dwyer. That's going to be Dwyer's second foul. That's going to be the team's fourth foul overall. So remain 69-60. Stegmeier will come back into the game. Engelbrecht will come out. Substitutions come in for the Chargers. And that will be Wacker as well as Reed. Hintz with the inbounds pass. Into Toby. 69-60 is the score. Minute 27 remains. Horseman gets it over to Putoff in the corner, gets double teamed, lets that one go out of bounds, and she thought it was going to be out on a Charger. And instead, now the referees will talk about it, and I have a feeling they might look over the footage. And that is what they will do. So they'll look over the footage. And this just right now, we'll keep it here, actually. And this right now, that just gives the Chargers an extra chance to talk things over, as well as the Oilers trying to keep the ball on their side. And right now, if it was the Oilers, don't be urgent with the ball. Keep ball security high, because if you don't and you lose those possessions, Hillsdale will easily get back into this one. And it could be a choppy last minute 20 right now. And now the Hillsdale's men's team, so right after this, warm-ups will begin for both sides for the men's. Hillsdale watching from afar from their side of the locker room, watching their women's team go up against the Oilers, and now the Oilers on that side chomping at the bit to get on this court once this game is over. But the Lady Oilers trying to get it done here tonight against the Chargers.
The Dick's Auto Supply player of the game is Krista Putoff.
So tonight's player of the game is Krista Putoff, and she's had a pretty good game tonight. Definitely been very, very aggressive down low, trying to get those boards and rebounds for her team. Shooting that three ball for the Hillsdale Chargers as Wacker makes it 69-63. Only down by 6 points, two threes, and you're good to go. A minute 04 left. We'll take the timeout with them. You are watching Oilers basketball on UFTV.
Wasbo Rental Properties is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio, and the surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to thesshermanhouse.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbo is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
69-63. Hillsdale gets a three in. Only down by 6 points. Oilers have to keep this lead. Toby gets it across the court to Stegmeier. Horseman getting guarded heavily by Dwyer and Porter. Back to Horseman, and right now if the Chargers don't need to give a foul, Stegmeier. And that's not what the Oilers wanted. Another miscue by the Oilers on offense, and the Chargers take it away. Porter will drive to the basket and gets fouled, and now she'll go to the line to shoot two free throws.
Oilers 30, Jenna Stegmeier. Her first team's second. Brady Porter shooting two.
At the line, shooting two is Porter. Misses the first free throw. Substitutions come in. Allerbrock comes in for Putoff. Boner comes in for Toby. And they bring in Engelbrecht for Stegmeier. Six seconds remains in the fourth period. Porter with another free throw. Misses that one as well, and what? Ball gets batted out of bounds, and that is a bad call. I don't know about that. It looked like to me that Hintz was trying to go after the rebound, but the ball got knocked out of her hands. And they're going to say it's Chargers ball. 69-63, still the score. 40.6 seconds remains. And we're going to go back to the TV cameras for another replay. And I'm going to keep it here. To me, it looked like when the ball came off the glass and into Hintz's territory, one of the Chargers players knocked it out of her hands. And I was kind of surprised by that call. And we'll see. We'll see what the referees will have to say about this one. But right now, Oilers, that's not what they wanted on the offensive side. Yes, they want to work ball security right now, but throwing it as a miscue is not helping their case out to win this one tonight. So they got to be careful. Referee still talking it over. And from my point of view, I can see how that play went down. And to me, and they're still saying that it's gonna be Chargers ball. So Chargers ball with 40.6 seconds left, 69-63. Inbounds pass by Reed, does get it in to Ott. Ott up top to Dwyer. Now over to Reed. Thought about the three, doesn't shoot it. Blair will shoot the three in the corner. Can't finish it off. Allerbrock trying to get the ball. She does! With 27 seconds left. She's on the right wing. She's getting double teamed. Ball gets slapped out of bounds, but the Oilers will keep the ball. Substitution comes in. Porter will come in. They'll take Blair out. Allerbrock will inbounds this one. 24.2 seconds left, 69-63. Oilers still on top. Does get it into Hintz. Hintz gives off to Allerbrock, and that double team play will begin, and the fouling will start. Five fouls overall for the Chargers. And now we go into single bonus. Allerbrock at the line to shoot 1-1. Misses the first free throw. And now they just changed it to double bonus. Makes the second, so 70-63. 7-point lead for the Oilers with 18 seconds left. And Horseman fouls Dwyer. That's going to be the team's third overall foul, so won't be going to the line at all for the Chargers. 17.8 seconds left. Porter trying to find who she wants to get it into. Does get into Dwyer. Dwyer drives baseline, gets it off to Ott for the three ball in the corner. Can't finish it off. Rebound comes away to Allerbrock, and they can try to dribble this one out. Gets it over to Hintz. Now throws it over to Boner. And over to Allerbrock, saves that one from going out of bounds, gets double teamed, clock should expire, and they're gonna call a timeout. And they probably should have just let that one go. We'll keep it here with 0.5 seconds left. 70-63, and that's what the Oilers wanted. Putting the pressure on the Chargers, and they fall. Ball security not really big for the Hillsdale Chargers in the second half. The Oilers did a great job of manning up on defense and being aggressive, sacrificing their body to get that ball. And with that free throw by Ellerbrock, that also helped them out as well towards the closing seconds. And the Oilers will come away with a win tonight against the Hillsdale Chargers. Coming out of the timeout, Hillsdale, and should be pretty simple with the inbounds pass. Gets it in to Horseman, and that's it. Clock expires. Lady Oilers win this one 70-63. Putoff was the player of the game for the Lady Oilers. We're gonna take a break until the men's game, where the men's take on the Hillsdale Chargers starting around 7:30. So 25 minutes put on the clock until that game starts. For this broadcast for UFTV, my name is Brandon Emsweller. Thank you for listening, and we'll be right back with men's basketball here on UFTV.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Wasbo Rental Property is a family-owned and operated residential rental company serving Findlay, Ohio and its surrounding areas. For over 50 years, Wasbo Rental Property has helped residents find the right apartment to fit their needs. Go to thesshermanhouse.net for more rental information or call 419-423-8321. Wasbro is proud to support the Findlay Media Network.
BioLogistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Because they understand that I...